Bheeshma. Bheeshma was the son of King Shantanu and goddess Ganga. Many children were born to them, but every child she used to throw away into the river Ganges. Shantanu was much displeased. When Bheeshma was born, Shantanu took hold of the child and refused to hand him over to her. She blessed the child and disappeared. Bheeshma was educated under great teachers and was a fund of knowledge, a living encyclopedia for all Dharmashastras. He was trained in the art of archery and warfare. There were none equal to him at the time. Once he had a duel with Parshurama for 21 days, but the fight was later abandoned by the intervention of great persons. Bhishma's father, Shantanu, fell in love with the daughter of a neighboring king. That king would give his daughter only if her offspring would be heir to the kingdom of Shantanu. Bhishma was already the heir. Bhishma consented to forego his claim for the kingdom, but the king suspected that Bhishma's sons might claim the right. So Bhishma promised to remain a bachelor for life. He brought that princess and gave her to his father. His father was much pleased for his chivalry and sacrifice and gave him a boon by which he got the power to relinquish his body according to his decision. Swachanta Maranam. Bhishma remained a bachelor till the end of his life. Bhishma was an ocean of knowledge, a man of strength and a great warrior. He was revered and respected by everybody. He was the eldest person in the whole family of the Kauravas and the Pandavas. He was called the grandfather, dominated on the battlefield for the first 10 days out of the 18 days during which the Mahabharata war lasted. He fought so fiercely that he appeared to destroy the Pandava army in no time. At one time, his fight was so devastating that Sri Krishna forgot his non-partisan policy and got down from the chariot of Arjuna, where he was acting as a driver, and ran to attack Bhishma with his Sudarshana Chakra, the divine discus. Arjuna ran after him, brought him back and saved the situation. At the last moment, at the request of Yudhishthira, Bhishma narrated to the Pandavas the secret of his weakness and the way to win over him. Then, while Shikhandi was fighting Bhishma, Arjuna joined him from the back and showered his arrows on Bhishma. Bhishma stood silent because he had resolved not to fight with Shikhandi, who was born as a female but later became a male. He was still a female in the chivalrous code of Bhishma. When Bhishma actually fell down in the war field, there was not even a small part of his body which was devoid of arrow pricks. So even when he fell down, his body was resting on a bed of arrows, as it were, but did not touch the earth. He had no support for his head to rest on. When others were running for getting pillows, Arjuna sent in 3 arrows into the ground below his head, and Bhishma rested his head over them comfortably. Bhishma felt thirsty. There was no water nearby. Arjuna went round Bhishma once in Pradakshina and sent an arrow into the ground, invoking goddess Ganga, and Ganga came out in a spout and Bhishma quenched his thirst. Bhishma began to praise Sri Krishna eloquently. Sri Krishna gave him solace that he would not be troubled by hunger, thirst, or by the pain of the wounds on the body till he chose to leave the body of his own accord. After the war ended and all funeral ceremonies concluded, Yudhishthira with all his brothers and Sri Krishna used to visit Bhishma every day and hear from him all the Dharmashastras, rules and regulations of every aspect of life. Political, social, economical, communal, etc. Many sages, kings and mahatmas used to assemble there for the satsang. One day when the satsang had almost finished, Draupadi, who was sitting by the side of Bhishma, had a hearty laugh to herself but tried to suppress it. Bhishma, who happened to notice, inquired of her the cause for the astonishment which she felt. She tried to evade and pass over, but he persisted that she should mention the reason. Then Draupadi explained, all this fund of knowledge was available in the person of the noble Bhishma when he was present in the court of Dhritarashtra, when a royal princess who was in monthly period was put to the worst shame. She was molested and an attempt was made to make her naked. At that time, not a word of these Dharmashastras was whispered anywhere nearby. Deshe kale cha patre cha tat danam sattvikam smritam. Adisha kale yaddanam apatre vyasya diyate tat tamasa mudam hritam. In the appropriate place, appropriate time and to the appropriate persons, not a single word of these Dharma Shastras was spoken. Now, after all the war had ended, when there is no more need for these sutras, they are perennially pouring out. This is all the wonder of wonders I felt within me. Bhishma accepted the truth of her statement. He merely surrendered himself to the Lord, who was the real stage manager. Ishvaraha sarva bhutanam hrideshe arjuna tishtati brahmayan sarva bhutani yan trarudani mayaya. It is said that the great war of the Mahabharata could not have been anything worth mentioning but for three persons who took part in it. They were Abhimanyu, son of Arjuna, against whom none of the heroes on the Kaurava side could stand and fight, even though he was only a youth. But they collectively destroyed him in a most unrighteous way. Bhishma, an old man, against whom none of the on the Pandava side could stand and fight, including Arjuna, till he accepted to be overpowered. And finally, Shri Krishna, the stage manager, pretended to do every effort for peace while planning for a major destruction. Bhishma was fully conscious till his end came, which he had fixed to take place in the northern movement of the sun. Till then, he was meditating on the Lord in the visible form of Shri Krishna and merged in him ultimately.